Way back in 2010, Google started talking about the importance of page loading speed. And just recently, they announced that their so-called speed update would, in fact, actually take speed formally into account when ranking. Remember, Google is highly focused on user experience, especially these days with respect to the mobile web, and there's little that can degrade a site experience more quickly than waiting an exceptionally long time for a page to load. So will Google's speed update really hurt you? While Google has not quantified how fast your site must be, nor said how slow is too slow, they have stated that sites that, quote, deliver the slowest experiences will be impacted. It behooves every site owner to optimize for speed because it supports both site ranking and business goals. Now, with respect to the latter, Google research has shown that a few seconds make all the difference between success and failure with your online strategy. Those studies found that about 40% of users bounce if page load takes longer than 3 seconds, and a mere 1 second with above the fold content. And what's the alternative effect of a fast-loading site? Users stay, obviously. And if they do, they're of course more likely to become customers. If you sell products online, fast-loading pages mean your visitors more effectively browse and check out. And if advertising is your game, fast-loading pages mean visitors more efficiently navigate, find, and consume content, staying longer to log more page views and impressions. In another study, Walmart found that conversions increased 2% for every 1 second increase in page speed, and incremental revenue grew 1% for every 100 millisecond improvement. Small changes can have big results. The bottom line is, page speed can have a profound impact on your business. Okay, so let's get into which elements of a page actually impact loading speed, after which I'll discuss a few options for taking corrective action. Now, there are probably too many to list exhaustively, but here are some of the most common. First off, oversized images. They are probably the biggest offenders. Images, of course, play an important role in driving interest in any site. By all means, I'm not saying we can do without them, but they can also play a big role in hurting site performance. And more images means more round trips from the browser to the server, and each trip takes time. And once downloaded, heavier images take longer to handle, slowing the rendering process even further. Another element that slows a page are line breaks. That is, in your code, additional spaces, comments, unnecessary lines, and so on. All of these increase the size of your code, and that affects the speed of your pages. I will talk later about how a process called minifying can help. External scripts, also known as render blocking, are another common one. They force the loading process to wait while being downloaded, which delays page rendering. External scripts can often be an important element of a page, but you should always evaluate their use, weighing the cost-benefit of using them, and consider alternatives when available. Network latency plays a huge role in page speed. On a 3G or third generation network, you can expect a delay of about 200 to 300 milliseconds before the page even starts loading, which is the time it takes for your browser to request the page and for the server to deliver it. On 4G, that delay improves to 50 to 100 milliseconds. At first blush, these seem like infinitesimal time increments. But keep in mind, as I already stated, you need to load the visible parts of your page, the content above the fold, in 1 second. And 1 second is a mere 1,000 milliseconds. So if the initial delay has already eaten up 300 milliseconds, you'll only have 700 milliseconds, less than 3/4 of a second left over to load all the components of your page, including images and other large elements. To break that down further, in those 700 milliseconds before the user sees the page requested, the browser will need to conduct a DNS lookup, execute all HTTP requests, execute the page code client-side, and finally, display the content, all in 700 milliseconds. Now, I know I said that number only applied to 3G, but despite all recent talk about 5G and all the miraculous speeds that will come with it, 3G is still the most pervasive worldwide connection speed. Users will invariably be accessing your site from 3G for a while to come. So how can you go about assessing where your site stacks up on page speed? There are a few tools that you can turn to. Google provides a few themselves. Google's Mobile Scorecard is a mobile benchmarking tool that allows you to compare the speed of multiple sites so you can see how you stack up against competitors. The tool uses latency data as a baseline that Google's collected from thousands of Chrome users across a dozen countries. In the tool, you can toggle between 3G and 4G to see how fast you and your competitors load on each. And along with this tool, Google also provides their so-called impact calculator to help put these insights into monetary terms. Here's how. After you've obtained your average page speed, you then enter data on your average monthly visitors, average order amount, and average conversion rate. And the impact calculator will return how much each incremental speed improvement means in added annual revenue. In other words, how much revenue you're missing out on due to your slow loading site. Note, the impact calculator's data comes from a report called The State of Online Retail Performance, which was released in April 2017 by Akamai. One of the more groundbreaking findings of the report was in quantifying how each second of delay in page load can hurt conversions by up to 20%. If you're a big e-commerce website, that can equate to millions, even billions of dollars. Google also provides a very useful tool appropriately called the PageSpeed tool. The PageSpeed tool analyzes your loading speed and provides suggestions for optimization, each with links to Google documentation. Another great one is Lighthouse, an open source automated tool for auditing a site's performance and accessibility. Here's how you use it. From a Chrome browser, right-click and choose Inspect from the menu shown. This opens the inspection panel. From there, you choose Audits from the top choices, which reveals the Lighthouse tool. You click the Perform an Audit button, which in turn reveals a list of available audit types. Check all the boxes for the audit you want to run, and click the Run Audit button. This will run an audit of the page and return insights, analysis, and what they call opportunities, aka areas for improvement. Like the PageSpeed tool, each area noted offers a link to Google reference docs that explain the implications of the findings and best practices for fixing issues. Which provides me a nice little segue discussing how to improve PageSpeed. Staying with the Lighthouse tool, let's now look at the area here labeled Diagnostics, and the item under that, the one labeled Critical Request Chains. If you expand that item, the order of fetching and rendering of various page components, and how long each of those takes to load. If page loading is an issue, it can tell you why your page might be loading slowly, and ways you can reorder or optimize those page components to load the page faster and prioritize to load first the above-the-fold components, those items the user sees first. This tactic is known as progressive loading, which is just another way of saying focusing the loading priority on the above-the-fold content, and then loading the below-the-fold stuff afterwards. This gives the user the illusion of a quick loading page, which serves to reassure them and overall improve bounce rate. And to that point of loading pages progressively, try to avoid and/or minimize the use of any render blocking external scripts, instead opting to place any JavaScript or CSS inline. Inline scripts serve to avoid the overhead of network requests, so opt for inline scripts as much as possible, or at least with above-the-fold content. And where inline scripts aren't possible, load them asynchronously, meaning waiting to load them until after first rendering the page. Granted, these approaches aren't always possible, especially when code maintenance makes it prohibitive, but they are definitely something to aspire to for speed optimization. Another important area to look at when optimizing page speed is your images. First and foremost, make sure your images are the right size. Believe it or not, I see pages all the time using huge images when a much smaller size will work just as well. This should be the lowest of low-hanging fruit. So resize your image dimensions to fit the need. This can save a ton of page weight. Also compress images. This can help page weight tremendously. There are two types of compression you should know about. Lossless, where your pages stay the same quality after compression, and lossy, where your images are reduced in quality. But the key benefit is that the file size is reduced more dramatically than lossless. Lossless is usually the first choice, for obvious reasons, but in some cases, lossy does make sense. If, for instance, you can afford to reduce quality when that won't hurt your design aesthetic. Adobe Photoshop is one common way to compress images. Another is using an online image compression tool. A free tool I love is called TinyJPG or TinyPNG. To use it, go to either tinypng.com or tinyjpg.com. Both URLs take you to the same page. Another good option is a sprite. A sprite is a method of trimming down the number of individual images on the page by grouping small images together into a single one. Now let's talk about minifying code. Remember I said how additional spaces, comments, unnecessary lines, and other extra things in your code contribute to its overall size, making it bigger and take longer to run? Well, the way to improve this is by minifying your code, which removes those things and shrinks it down to reduce loading time substantially. I provide a few links in the related tools area at the bottom of the video page to a few different resources you can use to minify your site code, so check those out. Another way to improve page speed is to leverage browser caching, which basically just means instructing the browser to collect some of your page files from the browser cache instead of requesting them from the server every time they're needed. I won't go into depth on the technical aspects of how you do this, but the quick answer is, you implement a piece of code that tells the browser to collect certain previously downloaded files from the local drive instead of from over the network. And because those items aren't being collected from the server, they come much faster, which boosts the overall speed of your page. Now that's a very simple explanation, but know that this is a good technique for improving page speed, so I recommend looking into it further or discussing it with your web developer. In the same related tools area, I provide a link to Google's overview of browser caching if you're interested. And finally, there are also some outside resources you can use to speed up your page loading. Google AMP, an acronym for Accelerated Mobile Pages, is one and is freely available. The basic gist of AMP is that you load your site into Google's cache, so when it's requested, it comes much faster from their cloud versus from your web server. What makes AMP really fast is that the pages preload in the background of search listings, so they're at the ready to be delivered right after a user clicks on them from the search results. And Google has recently hinted at releasing another option, similar but alternative to AMP, which would be a set of web standards that offer instant loading for non-AMP content too. This recent news from Google was the result of pressure from publishers that are worried that they're giving up too much control to Google. With these web standards, which are based on AMP, publishers would, in theory, have all the advantages of AMP while sticking with their own infrastructures. Again, check out related tools area for links to Google's overview of AMP if you're interested.